1 Corinthians 14:4. The one who speaks in a tongue edifies himself. So what are you doing when you're speaking in tongues? You're edifying yourself. You're building yourself up. I use the illustration. It's like, you know, sometimes when we get in ministry and we're ministering, we kind of get drained. Anybody experience that? Well, you know, you get drained. It's like your batteries are being discharged. You need to recharge. You need to build yourself up. And the best way to do it is to plug into the Holy Spirit. Plug in. Just like you're plugging into an outlet, the Holy Spirit, you plug in by tongues, and that speaking in tongues, isn't this hard to understand? But it's supernatural. See, the supernatural stuff you can't examine with a microscope. You can't logically figure it out. It's supernatural. But as you speak in tongues, you are actually building your spirit man. He's getting strong. He's getting built up. The spirit man inside of you is charging his spiritual batteries. That's why it's so important that we ministers, or you that are going to be ministers, we need to have those batteries, spiritual batteries, charged up all the time. And the only way to do that is speaking in tongues. So the one who speaks in a tongue edifies himself, but the one who prophesies edifies the church. Now, today I was kind of meditating about tonight, and I want to do something. I'm going to ask you to do something. One by one, starting on this side, every single person, I want you to stand up, and I want you to tell me your first name only. Just your first name. Every single person. Okay, we're going to start over here. Go ahead. To complete with the mandate, to complete with the command that I gave you, being a teacher, being a student, to complete with my will, I gave you the order. And then what did you have to do? You had to speak. You had to stand up. Was it comfortable? Was anybody really comfortable with that? You're a knockout anyway. You know, just the fact to stand in front of people, it puts some people kind of, I'm not comfortable with this. I don't like to be in front of people. I don't like to be shown silly. You know, this is silly. I don't like this. And then to say your name, there was a time I couldn't even do what we just did. I hated it. I hated being in front of people. It was a torment to me to be in front of people. But then to stand up, everybody looking at you, embarrassment, and then all of a sudden you have to do something. What do you have to do? You have to speak. What did you have to do to speak your name? Asking you a question. What did you have to do? What did your body have to accomplish to speak your name out in front of all these people? What happened? tell me. And you people that are good with anatomy and all that kind of stuff, tell me the function of speech. How does it happen? You have to inhale. That's action, right? I mean, if you're not breathing, you're dead anyway, so just go home. All right, and then what do you have to do? You have to use your vocal cords. Could anybody in this place tonight speak without using the vocal cords? Could any of you tell me your name without blowing the air past the vocal cords to get a sound? Anybody? Could anybody speak a word without forming some kind of twisting of the tongue or the mouth in such a way to produce a certain sound? Anybody? You have to do that, don't you? You have to breathe. You have to use your vocal cords. You have to open your mouth. You have to use what God has given you naturally so that the supernatural can come in. If you don't do your part in the natural realm, the Holy Spirit will not be able to do his part in the supernatural realm. I've prayed for so many people who receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Many people receive, and I tell you what, many people don't. Now, the Bible says that every single one receives. But what do you do with somebody that refuses to do the natural? Refuses. I mean, they're up in the prayer line, and they don't say nothing. I mean, it's like they've got a lock on their lips. Don't say anything. Let me give you some clues here, guys. The infilling of the Holy Spirit. And if you think about this, this is very true. Our part is to flow with Him. We flow with Him. But in order to speak in tongues, I have got to breathe. I have got to let air pass over my vocal cords. I have got to move my mouth and my tongue to form a sound. 1 Corinthians 14 says, every language, every word has a significance on the earth, let alone the angelic. Every noise has a significance. But we think, well, I don't understand. So therefore, because I don't understand, I will not speak. And because I'm too prideful to do it, then I will not do it. You've got to flow with Him. The same in the gifts of the Spirit. You've got to flow with the Holy Spirit. He will never violate this precious thing that He gave, and He set mankind apart with that in the very beginning. He created man in His own image, and He gave him a free will. You have got to engage your will. You do not engage your will, God will not violate your will. You understand what I just said? He will not force something on you that your will refuses to receive. Everything that will happen tonight is because you want it. That's why that we have to come with a hunger. We have to come with a thirst. We have to come ready with an anticipation to be flowing with the Holy Spirit. I've got to do the natural so that the supernatural will come. And when the supernatural comes, it will not come through the logic. you will not be able to discover it. You will not be able to determine in your own way, oh, I know what I'm saying. You will not know what you're saying. You know what you're going to be doing? Hear me, guys. You have got to come to a place of complete surrender. Even if it's going to make you feel stupid, silly, embarrassed. You know, I sometimes wonder. It's okay that, you know, I have wonders. You know, I wonder sometimes. I wonder if God doesn't give the evidence of speaking in tongues as the evidence of the infilling. I wonder if he hasn't done that simply because man has got to come to this place of total abandonment. If he's prideful, spiritual pride, guess what my Bible says? My Bible says that God resists him. So if God is resisting the prideful, how is that man going to receive the baptism? He's prideful. And one of the manifestations of pride is, I don't want to look silly. I don't want to look bad. Don't make me look bad. Don't make me look bad. Understand what I'm saying? But a humble man will just say, here I am. I want it. Jesus, I'm asking for the infilling of the Spirit. And at that point, that man has got to step out in faith. Passivity is not going to get you filled. Healing, same principle. You've got to step out of it. The gifts of the Spirit, you have to step out into it. You have the initial impulse of the Spirit. But then you have to do your natural part. You don't understand what's being spoken into your spirit. But faith has got to take it from the Spirit, the reception, the impulse, the push, the Holy Spirit trying to influence you. He does that to your spirit. Spirit to spirit. So it comes in as an impression. It comes in as an impulse. But then it's coming in here to my inner man, because the Bible says from the innermost parts of your being will flow rivers of living water. From the innermost parts of your being will come this impulse, this leading to make a noise, to say a word, to use something to communicate. But then it's got to come out here. From here to here is a big step of faith. Right here. This is where it's at. From here to here. A lot of people will not take that step. It's there, but it won't come through. So what do you have to do? You have to step in, but you have to take that impulse, and then you have to bring it. You have to bring it out. You have to bring it and manifest it by your natural abilities. You manifest that which the Holy Spirit is enabling you or giving you the sound to make. You need to hear and obey and do that. I will not listen. If I'm praying for you and I'm speaking in tongues, I am not going to ask you to repeat what I'm saying. In my opinion, that is not right. But you do need to hear, or you need to receive, because you probably won't hear nothing, but you will feel the desire to flow, to come in with Him. And at that point, you need to open your mouth and make a sound. You need to make a sound. Every sound, every syllable, every word has got a significance. Isaiah chapter 28. Isaiah chapter 28. I can't remember the verse. Isaiah chapter 28. Verse 11, it says, "Indeed, He," capital He "will speak to this people through stammering lips and a foreign tongue." Stammering lips and a foreign tongue. We're not asking for eloquency. I really don't care. What I'm asking for is faith. I'm asking you to step out. Even if it sounds like a stammer, a stumbling block, you're just stumbling all over yourself. Do it! Do it! Step out in faith and do it! Let that stammering tongue be glorifying Jesus in it. And yes, amen. Thank you. I'll preach to you. Everything that you do, everything that you say, when you don't know it and you speak it out in faith, guess what? Guess what? Jesus is saying, good. Great. Keep going. Keep doing it. Keep doing it. You've got to keep it up. You've got to keep it up. Do not throw in the towel. That's in Spanish saying. Don't relinquish. Keep on keeping on, keep on pressing in. And I'll tell you what, someday that stammer will turn into words, and then words will change. When you're in spiritual warfare, the words change. The intensity changes. It all changes, all up to the Holy Spirit that guides you. But you know what? When I speak in tongues, I don't have to think about what I'm saying. That's the cool part. I don't have to try to formulate in my mind about what to say, because it's the Spirit of God that's doing it. And I'm just flowing. Say to your neighbor, let's flow.
Come on, flow.
Let's flow. Let's flow. Let's just flow with Him. And I'll guarantee you, the first thing is that the devil's going to do, he's going to come up to you and he's going to say, "That sounds so stupid. Why are you doing this?" You just come back to Him and say, "Because I am a son of God. And I will step out in faith every time. And I will be a pleasure to my Lord. I will please Him. Even in this ridiculous moment when I think that I'm being stupid, I don't care. I'll be stupid. I'll be silly. I'll look horribly silly. I don't care. He's worth everything. He's worth it all." And that's where you've got to come to. You've got to come to that place that nothing is going to impede you. Nothing is going to hold you back. Nobody's going to criticize you. Just flow. We need to write a song about that, Eric. You need to write a song about flow, flow, flow. Amen. Okay. Are you ready? Y'all ready? All right. So what do you have to do? There are some things that you have to do. The Bible says that you will receive, but what do you have to do? You have to ask. You have to seek. You have to knock. And be persistent. Persistent. And then You've got to receive. You've got to speak. You've got to receive and speak.